Hi there, it's Billy Carmen with Wizard Industries, and today I want to tell you about our latest new product. This is the Lumber Wizard 4 laser line metal detector, made specifically for woodworkers to find lost pieces of metal, buried pieces of metal inside of recycled or reclaimed wood, all the way to even new wood. You never know what's going to be inside a piece of wood. It could be a railroad spike, a nail, a screw, some barbed wire, anything that's been left up against a tree and grown around, or anything that's been driven into a tree, or a piece of reclaimed or recycled wood, like nails or screws. You don't want to hit those with your planer, your bandsaws, your sanders, or what have you. So the very best practice is to take the Wizard 4 and use that to scan your wood before you run it through your power tools. A very simple tool to use. You simply turn it on. When you turn it on, it's going to beep one time, the laser will fire one time, and the green light will just flash about every 3 seconds. Now, something that's important for all metal detectors, including the Wizard 4, is they need to be properly tuned based on what environment they're in. I'll give you an example. We're in California. If I tune this in California and ship it to Idaho, it's probably going to be needing to be tuned again, simply because there's something called ground balance that affects all metal detectors. Also, temperature can affect the tuning. Fortunately, the Lumber Wizard is very easy to tune. The way that you do it is you take a little tiny screwdriver here, like I have in my hand. There's a tuning screw right here. You rotate that screw all the way to the left. When you do, it's going to start beeping, as you hear now. If we return that screw to the right, just slowly rotate it to the right, we want to be right on the threshold of where it stops beeping. Right there. At that point, that little green light is going to flash about every 3 seconds, letting you know that it's in tune and ready to detect metal. And again, that tuning is very important, so make sure that you get accustomed to tuning it correctly. Once it's tuned, now let's take some example pieces of metal. I'm going to take a deck screw. It's about 1.5 inch, maybe 2 inch long screw. We'll pass it underneath. You see the laser fires, letting us know that we're right on top of that screw. Let's take a flattened out L bracket here. A little bit bigger, so obviously it's going to pick that up from much farther away. We're about 4 inches away right now for that piece of metal, which is about 2 inches long, maybe 1/2 inch wide, and looks like it's about 3/32 of an inch thick. Now you notice it's going to pick that up at about 4 inches away. We go back to our little 2-inch screw. It's going to find that at about 1.5 to 2 inches away. We have a part of a piece of paneling nail here. It's going to find that at about 1 to 1.5 inches away. The orientation of the metal is obviously a factor in detection as well. If we hold this nail straight up, it's going to detect it at a further distance, opposed to if we hold it flat, parallel to the detector. It's going to pick it up at a shorter distance, simply because this detector is detecting a piece of metal based on its orientation and its size. Since we're holding it at the tip here, it sees that metal is a thicker piece of metal, which actually it's not. If you hold it this way, it's thinner, and it's going to pick it up at a closer distance. We can go all the way down to a little screw. This is about 1/2 inch long. Looks like it's about 1/8 inch diameter. Again, it's going to pick that up at about 1.5 inches. Now we have a tiny little fragment here, a sharp object, by the way, the tip, about a 3/8 inch long piece of a sewing needle. Let's pass that underneath, and you can see that we have to be at about 1/2 inch, maybe 5/8 to 3/4 of an inch away. Now obviously we're using this primarily for checking the surface of the wood. We're ideally, the most use for this detector is people that are doing planing. Now you're not going to be planing an inch of wood off. You're going to be planing a very small surface scan across the top of that piece of wood just to peel the top surface off. Then you run this detector across that wood again. And now you know that you're checking it every time you pass a piece of wood through your planer. You should always, to be safest, run the detector across it again. Now let me give you an example here. We'll turn it on. It's going to beep one time because, well, it's actually picking up the pieces of metal here. So we'll set it down, just let it do its thing. Now, if I take this screw and I just hold it in my hand, like you see here. I don't have any rings. There's no metal tape to my fingers or anything like that. We're holding that screw right under that board. We take our lumber wizard, we scan it over the top, and there it is. You can see the laser will fire, and that's telling us where that piece of metal is. We take, obviously, a bigger piece of metal. It's going to detect it even easier, a little farther away. And we're running this across a 2x4, so it's checking all the way through that 2x4 to find it. Now, if we were sitting the metal on top, which you wouldn't need a detector if you're seeing the metal on top of the metal, on top of the wood, rather, but as you can see here, it's picking it up from a couple of inches away. So again, tuning, very important. Understanding how to use it, I always suggest take a sample piece of metal just so you can get accustomed to it, and that should keep you in safe practice to reduce damaging your tools and equipment. Now, the Lumber Wizard has been on the market now for about, going on 12 years. So has the Little Wizard. This is the little brother, if you will, to the unit. A smaller detector. This product sells for $149.95 retail. This one sells for $19.95. Now, this doesn't have a laser in it. It also does not have as powerful of a coil as the Lumber Wizard. However, for $20, this is great insurance. And if you're the kind of woodworker that's just doing some occasional scanning, you're pretty confident that your wood doesn't have metal in it, this is going to take you a long way. It's not going to replace this, but it's a really good second. So if we turn this puppy on, again, dial it right to the edge there. This one has a fine-tuning adjustment, just like the Lumber Wizard does, but it also has a tuning control on the side, so you can control the sensitivity. So let's put it at its most sensitive point. Again, that's going to be right there at the point between beep and not beep. That's where you want to put the dial. And we'll take, again, our little screw. And it looks like we're about 3/4 of an inch to an inch away on the size of this screw. We'll take this one, probably close to the same distance, a little bit closer. We take, obviously, our bigger piece of metal here. It's going to find it at a larger distance. Or that tiny little, very sharp, ouch, needle, portion of a needle. And it's finding that that appears to me to be about 1/4 of an inch. So there you have it, the Wizard 4 with the laser inside. That'll give you a visual indication. As you can see here, we'll put our piece of metal under it, scan it over, and you can see that red light right there giving us a visual reference. So we have the Lumber Wizard 4, the Little Wizard 2. Both of these products are available at woodworkersupply.com. Go to woodworker.com, which is the greatest web address for any woodworker on the planet because it's so easy to remember. Woodworker Supply has been around for 40 years supplying top-notch tools to woodworkers, and we are very proud to be a part of their offerings. So there you have it. Again, I'm Billy Carmen with Wizard Industries, and happy woodworking out there.